sun's up. It's a little after 12. Make breakfast for myself. Leave the work for someone else. People say, they say that it's just a phase. They tell me to act my age. Well, I am. On this perfect day, nothing's standing in my way.
On this perfect day,
when nothing can go wrong. It's the perfect day. Tomorrow's gonna come too soon.
I could stay
forever as I am. On this perfect day. Sun's down, a little after 10. I pick up all my friends in my Mercedes Benz. Wake up, don't tell me it's just a dream.
Look what we have here. Deck paint. And I gotta vacuum out my... I need to vacuum out my car. But yeah. And we got some insect killer. And then some odds and ends here. I have to bring these rocking chairs out here into the yard and get them all squirted off to get all the dirt off of them, and then I'm going to let them dry here in the sun and spray paint them. If I can't spray paint them today, I'll spray paint them tomorrow, because I have to make sure the wood is good and dry. Otherwise, the paint's not going to stick, but it's still pretty hot out here. And then I got masking tape, or not the masking tape, but painter's tape. And I need to start taping so we can paint the deck tomorrow morning, first thing.
Mom.
What?
Dead.
I don't know. He might have gone back upstairs. I don't know. Hopefully that's the plumber's leaving, since 8:30 this morning. We've had two plumbing trucks. The plumbers have been here since 8:30 putting in a new water filtering softening system. And so I think that they're done. I hope that they're done, because we've been without water all day today. And so anyway, yeah, hope that they're done. Harry's gonna go check that out. I can now run some water. Look, it's 5:22, and I can now fill up my sink and wash up dishes and wash off the counters. And you can see outside I have blue tape. So we've got that all trimmed off so we can start painting the deck in the morning. But I wanted to show you these before I go downstairs and show you our water system. Look at these. They're pretty cool. They look like little stones. Let me take a pink one out. But see those? That is, I'll show you. It's sugar. They're little sugar pieces. And every color has a different flavor. Like these pink ones are strawberry. That's lime. That's orange. I'm not sure what that is, because I think that's blueberry, or that's blueberry, that's blackberry, and those are cherry. and those taste really good. My husband got those when he was in Baltimore. So this is it. Look at that. Now, we used to have a tank that was like that. That was over here. This is where you put soda ash. This is from our well that comes up and through the pipes and everything. And then this is the soda ash. Then it goes over here. I don't know what this is. I don't know what this is. And then this is where you put the salt so that it softens the water. So this is like a whole purification system. It's a soft water system and pH, because the pH in the water was really, really harsh, and it's bad on the plumbing. And quite honestly, since we've lived here, this is the third hot water tank. There was the original one when we moved in here. Then the bottom, it started leaking at the bottom. See all that rust? Because rusty water. And they said it was because the water was really, really hard, and like all the sediment from the minerals that would settle at the bottom of the tank, and it would actually eat like a hole through it. So we replaced that, then it did it again. And so that's what this is. And I told my husband, we've had that tank now for probably about, I want to say, a year, year and a half. And before, you know, we have any more problems and any other problems, because we're constantly having a plumber here, we had to do something. So this is everything that was needed to solve all of our water issues. And it took them all day. They got here at 8:30. It's now 5:30. It took them all day, two guys, to do that. So now I've squirted off my rocking chairs. They're drying. I'm not going to spray paint them tonight. While Harry's spray painting, Harry's painting the deck tomorrow, I'm going to go ahead and spray paint those and maybe paint the bridge, and that's all. So I'm going to go upstairs and get a shower. I need a shower. Harry ran to go pick up some sandwiches over at Capriotti's. We're going to get Philly cheesesteaks. So then I'll get my shower, get my jammies on, and eat my sandwich. Well, that is what color. That's the first coat. It'll get darker the more coats we put on it. And now I'm on my way out the door to go paint rocking chairs. Well, I put two coats of spray paint on, and I'm going to let that dry and come back out and see what are the touch-ups I need to do. And across the street, over in the field, they're getting ready to plant, so they got a big tractor over there, and it's getting kind of loud. And Harry went to go get different rollers, because the rollers that I got from I gotta take all these to the garbage. The rollers that I got from Home Depot yesterday, they were not rolling correctly, and so he had to stop painting. And this is actually really dry over here, so I'm gonna go ahead and let the girlie's out while he's getting that. It's looking nice. Oh boy. I gotta go to Lowe's. I'm gonna go get a different color for all here and here. Two coats of duck paint. Harry is still painting. And all we have to do tomorrow is touch up. We got a little touching up right over on this board here. And I got to get some of our old paint, and I'll have to touch up over there where I nicked it. But anyway, there we go. And I can't pan around because Harry does not want to be filmed. So look at this. When I woke up this morning and put the dogs out, the deck looked just like this, just like I showed it to you last night after we finished painting. And about 45 minutes, an hour ago, I walked by the door here and I happened to see this. So I'm like, what is going on in various places? So I went online to look it up, and they said that morning dew on fresh paint can cause this, and they said in a few days these spots should disappear. So we'll see. And if they don't disappear, they said you should roll another coat of paint over it and it should be fine. But see, you could see here where the kitty's paws are. So they were out here this morning, obviously, with the dew, and that's from their wet paws. So that's probably what it is. It's just the dew. It should go away. We're hoping it goes away, because I don't want to have to roll any more paint, because that means, because this stuff has to get back on this deck today, which means we would have to move things around again and do a little bit of painting. I'm hoping that's not going to be the case. Hopefully it'll just go away on its own. But I do like the color, and this was supposed to have been a dark brown. We got the same kid at Lowe's that mixed this paint, that mixed my front door paint. And as you know, he didn't get my green right from, for my front door. I told you it wasn't the right color green. Well, that's not brown, dark brown anyway. But I'm not going to complain, because it is a nice color. The only thing is, because it's a lighter color, it's going to get dirty. I mean, the deck gets dirty, but you know what I mean. It will show the dirt more. Let me show you. This board here, that is the original deck color that we had. So see the difference? See how light this is? And it was supposed to have been darker than that. I wish I had the color chart when I took it to the kid and I had it circled what I wanted. He never gave it back. But anyway, I'm just going to go to Lowe's and go get another one, because I'm thinking about complaining to Lowe's and getting my money back because it wasn't the right color. I mean, this is, I can live with it, but I would have preferred to have, you know, the color that I originally went in there for. So anyway, I walked on both of these with my bare feet. This is the redwood color, is the bare deck over paint. And this one is that Valspar from Lowe's. And the Valspar, I have to say, has more grit in it, because it's supposed to be, I got that slip knot so that you can not worry about, you know, slipping on your deck when it gets really wet, especially like in the winter and that sort of thing. So it does have a little bit more grit than the bear. And obviously the bear is spotting. Of course, this is kind of light. It might be hard to see any spotting, but quite honestly, I don't see any spotting at all. So I'm disappointed that Lowe's gave me the wrong color. But at the same time, I don't have white spots on my deck the next day, like the bear paint. So anyway, we do need to do a little bit of touching up today in a few places. We will do that. I got some high resistant heat spray paint for the grill. I'm going to paint the grill. You see what I did here? I left the old deck stain like that, and then I have then the redwood there. And I did that so, you know, as people are walking on the sidewalk here coming up, you know, obviously it breaks up the staircase a little bit. Because believe it or not, we've had people trip on these stairs. I've even tripped on these stairs. And especially being on the deck and you're moving around, you're moving backwards, and you think you've got a lot of deck space because, you know, from your side vision, you see the same color. You think that there's a lot of, you know, room left to go, and then you step back and boom, you know, you hit that right there. That's why I wanted to have the different colors to break up the stairs. It took us about 5.5-6 hours. Harry, he didn't paint this by himself. I had to come out and I had to help him paint. And it took us about 5.5-6 hours, you know, between painting the first coat, then waiting about an hour or so for it to dry, then coming back out. And the reason why it took two of us to do it, because that paint with the sandy, gritty stuff that's in it, it does not spread very well. You know, like regular paint, you can put it on your roller and you can do like a whole big area, you know, before you have to refill your roller. Mm-mm. Not with this stuff. You put it on your roller, you roll up, you roll back, you roll up, it, you know, in just a little area, and you have to refill your roller. It took forever to paint this deck, and that's what Harry, he told me. He said, you're going to have to come help me. He goes, I won't get this done today if you don't help me. So both of us did it yesterday. It's going to be loud because Harry's coming out of the shed with the tractor. I've been spray painting all morning different pieces of furniture, and this wrought iron little flower cart is in need of being painted. And I have this white paint left over. That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to spray paint it white, and then if I don't like it, I'll go look at other spray paints some other time when I'm out and about and see about changing the color. But I think white in here will be kind of nice because we got white there in the daisies over here. And yeah, we need something to, a light color to make it pop over here because we got lots of green. So there we go. I just brushed it off as good as I can. There was mud that was caked at the bottom, but I didn't want to wash it because then I'd have to let it sit out in the sun to dry before I could paint. And these wheels get buried down here in the mulch area anyway, so I'm not too worried about the bottom part of the wheels. I used a can and a half of spray paint. I probably need that other half of the can to just touch up places, but it's going to be okay because it's outside. It's supposed to look, you know, weathered and that sort of thing. So yeah, two full cans is what I probably needed for that cart. But anyway, I got to let that dry. And I'll take you quickly over here. I did my touching up of my paint. And here's the bad news for me. When we had our deck painted, the other color that we painted it, you know, that you've seen, it was called weathered paint or something like that. We got it over at Sears, and their paint machine wasn't working so good the one day that we went there, because we said, this paint, it's not exactly the right color. They went and they rematched it to the right color. So we had extra cans. Well, the can that I found that had the paint marked on it that said weathered paint, it must have been the other one, because when I went to touch up there, see that? And I figured, you can see where it's lighter. So I figured if that happened, that's okay. I'm gonna wait till next weekend because it's supposed to rain all this coming week off and on. So I'm not gonna be able to paint this week. I'm not gonna paint today because we got 60% chance of rain tonight and I don't want it getting all wet. So I'll wait till next weekend, hopefully. But I'm gonna have to take that can of paint that I have where I did this, and I'm gonna have to come along here, you know, all the way down over there to the bushes. I'm not gonna go through the bushes because you don't see it, but just everywhere where you see it. So that'll take me, what, you know, half hour, 45 minutes at the most to, and I just need one coat on there, I don't need two. So anyway, I was a little bit bummed out about that. I was also thinking, and this is maybe what I might do. I think I'll do this. Instead of having that, the deck paint that I have, I think, see how I have this board here? I'm thinking about just going ahead too and taking that same color to put down, you know, like here to come around, you know, that board there. And I think that's what I'm going to do. Again, that breaks the steps up. Because the more that I'm looking at this, this color is not too far off from that's already on there. And so it's not like it breaks up the steps, you know. The whole thing is about seeing the steps. And something else we're going to do, we're going to get solar lights. They had them over at Walmart. I hope they still have them. If they don't, I'm sure Home Depot or Lowe's has them. But they're like this. They're squared. And they're solar lights. And you screw them, like, you know, onto there. So we're going to put one here and one there. And then up on that board, even with it, we'll put one and one like that. And then that way, when people are coming through here, like my kids are coming at night, or like my kids sometimes, they like to have fires with their friends and that at nighttime. This way, they'll definitely see the steps now. But still, by breaking it up with the paint, people see the steps during the day. And I'm really a stickler about these steps because, as I've said, people have tripped on them and fallen, and I'm one of those people. But even people that have come to our house, they've tripped on them. My mother-in-law even fell on them one time, but we've had some of the kids' friends have fallen. And because you can't tell, you know, you see all one color, you think it's all one big deck, you know. So anyway, that's my whole reasoning for breaking it up for the day, but then having the lights to break it up for the night. So with that being said, we took all the tiles off, and this used to be brown, and I spray painted it black so it matches everything. And I spray painted my chimney thing and the little fire pit cage thing that goes on there and the grill. So I put the dragonfly birdhouse and butterfly up. It was the first time this season because I knew we'd be painting. That's why I didn't bother putting them up. So that's done. The only thing we have to do is get the two trees for there and over here. So here we go. A last little look. Like this. And then I'm going to take you and show you my flower. Look at my roses today. Aren't they so pretty? And I do have my bug spray that I need to get out here and spray. Probably going to have to wait till after all the rain. But look. So nice. And there we go. I got to get new pots because those are all cracking. I'm going to have to transplant all my little viney things.